my strength this hour, Jesus. You're my deliverer, yes, you are, Jesus.
The goodness of Jesus. I'm Vivian Brown. Thank you so very much for joining us today. Well, we're going to jump into the third part of The Perfect Storm. But if you have not had an opportunity to see part one and part two, don't worry. They're right on the site for you, right on the channel. Let's go ahead and open up with a prayer, and we're going to jump right into it. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so very much this day. We love you, Father. We adore you this day, Father. We thank you so very much for sending your only begotten Son, Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. We thank you so very much, Father. Father, we know that you saw fit to give us a measure of faith. Father, we ask that you help us use that faith that you have already given us, Father, to help with these, to conquer these perfect storms in our lives, Father. Father, we ask that you continue to shower us with your love, Father. I ask this day that those that are crying out to you, Father, those that are going through their perfect storms right now, help this word, Father, to get through to them, Father. Help them to understand how to handle these perfect storms. Father, we have gone over already pretty much what can occur and the elements from the perfect storm. But this day, Father, I ask that you see fit to shower them with your love. Father, those that are right now dealing with stressful situations, Father, things that are really pulling them down in their lives, Father, I ask that you lift them up, Father, and let them know that you are who you say you are. Father, let them know that you can do everything that you say you can do. Father, let them know that you are the great I am. You are everything that they need for you to be. Father, you are omnipotent. Father, you can do all things. Father, we thank you and we love you, Father. Give those the eyes to see and the ears to hear your word, Father, this day. I ask that you give them a heart, Father, that is open to receive your word. Allow each and every person that viewed this video to receive what it is that they need to receive from your word this day. We love you, Father, and we thank you so very much for seeing fit again to send us your only begotten Son, Jesus. In his name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Woo, amen this day. All right, what a wonderful day. Thank you so very much for tuning in this day. Well, we're going to go ahead and jump right into it. The perfect storm. How do we handle it? That is our question for today. Well, quite often we have the tendency to handle our perfect storms, our pain and everything that comes from it, the way that the world tells us we should handle it. Quite often we disregard what God says because we're in the flesh here, and quite often when we're in pain, we try to find a quick fix. So I wrote down a few ways that we have a tendency to handle our perfect storm. The first way I've noticed is the world wants us to believe that we should handle the pain that comes from our perfect storm simply by using medication. We need to take antidepressant. They want us to pop a pill and basically keep it moving.
And there's concern that cases of everyday sadness are increasingly being medicalized.
There was so much to do at White Leap, thought Elizabeth.
Julia Llewellyn Smith found it tough going after the birth of her first child, and when she went to see a GP, she was shocked by the response.
I said to her, I'm not depressed, I'm just exhausted and having a bad time with a new baby. And she said, no, you're depressed. I want to give you Prozac. You will feel very better very soon. And it really was quite a struggle to convince her that I didn't want or, in my opinion, need antidepressants.
Instead, Julia went to group counselling, and once the nights improved, so did her mood. But many patients are happy to take the pills. 53 million prescriptions for antidepressants like Prozac and Seroxat were handed out last year, a record high.
I don't think my profession are giving out antidepressants when they're not needed. But I think if there is a long waiting list for talking therapies, and there certainly is in the areas that I work, it may be rather than seeing a patient get worse depression and risk their life, it may be that the GP appropriately gives antidepressants as a bridge.
Taking the tablets brings with it the risk of addiction, and there are calls for more research to understand how antidepressants are being used. But for some, they're undoubtedly the crutch they need to make life bearable. Emma Birchley, Sky News.
Another way I wrote down that we have the tendency to handle our perfect storm is we listen to people when they say, girl, go on a shopping spree. You know, that'll make you feel better. Get a makeover.
You want to know a big secret? The cucumber does nothing. This is something we make up.
The third way you may have someone to tell you to handle your perfect storm is by thinking nothing but positive thoughts. That'll eliminate everything. Don't think about all those negative things. Don't think about anything that happened to you. Just think positive thoughts. I don't believe that I can just have positive thoughts and that's going to eliminate the painful elements that came right along with my perfect storm.
In a speech recently, I was asked, why don't we just focus on the positives and forget the negatives? Well, I don't like to think about the negatives, so I think we should just focus on the good things that we do and try to do them better, is what they said. Well, that all sounds good, but the problem is it doesn't work very well. For one, it ignores the impact that our constraints have on those around us. We don't live in isolation, and believe me, just thinking about the positive will not take away the impact of the negative. A one-sided focus does not work.
So let's see what God has to say about these three things that I just mentioned to you. Let's start off with pill popping. What does God say about antidepressants? What does he say when we use antidepressants to deal with those perfect storms? Well, let's take a look at John chapter 16, verse 33. It says, I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. So God right here tells us that to look to him for our peace and pretty much not the things of the world. Well, let's take a look at the second one. What does God say about going on shopping sprees, you know, just spending money, making sure we're all made over? Take a look at Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. What does God say about positive thoughts? Well, let's take a look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Jesus Christ for you. Amen, amen. So pretty much, have, of course, positive thoughts, but we want to, from what I'm getting from this scripture, we want to constantly pray without ceasing. We want to continue to meditate on God's word. We want to give him praise in all of our circumstances, and of course, give him thanks in all of our circumstances, no matter what they are. So what I've learned is that the world focuses on the surface. They are always masking what is going on with us. But from God's word, he focuses on the heart. He really truly wants to make sure that we are healed from within out. Well, of course, in studying how we should handle our perfect storm, I wanted to go into God's word to see how his other servants handled their perfect storms and really study what they did. Well, of course, the perfect servant of God that I thought would be a great example for us was King David. Now, of course, we know that he committed his sin with Bathsheba, and of course, he murdered her husband. So we do know that he really contributed to his perfect storm with his sin.
The king is never above his God. You abused your power. You took everything from your most loyal servant. You took his wife. Then you took his life. You think God doesn't see everything?
I am his chosen one.
For the contempt you have shown the Lord, he will bring disaster on your house. We shall see.
But let's take a look at Psalms chapter 34, verses 4, verses 18 and 19. It reads, I sought the Lord, and he answered me. This is what David is saying that he did. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. Amen. Okay, I have one more for you with David. Now, this particular verse is Psalm 62, verses 5 through 8. And in these verses, he is telling us, when we go through our perfect storms, how we should handle. For God alone, O my soul, wait in silence. For my hope is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation, my fortress. I shall not be shaken. On God rest my salvation and my glory. My mighty rock, my refuge is God. Trust in him at all times, O people. Pour out your heart before him, and God is a refuge for us. Now, the key word that I picked up after reading David's story again was faith. David truly believed in God. He believed every word from God, that he is who he says he is, and that he could do everything that he said he can do. So he truly trusted God. I mean, he didn't have a choice. His situation, that situation that he was in, he had to repent, turn away from his sins, of course, and just trust God. Let's take a look at what faith says. Hebrews 11 verse 1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is not something that we can purchase, is not something that someone can give to us, and it's not something that we can sell to someone else. So you may ask the question, well, how do we get it? Well, I'm glad you asked that question. Let's go to Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9. It reads, for by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast about it. Jesus poses the question this day, who do you say that I am? As you go through your perfect storm, do you say that he is Jehovah Jireh? If so, you must believe, you gotta believe that he is your provider. Jehovah Shalom? If so, you gotta believe that I am the Prince of Peace. Jesus says this day, who do you say that I am? Do you say I'm Alpha? Alpha and Omega? If so, you gotta believe that I am the beginning and the ending of every circumstance that you're in. Jesus says this day, who do you say that I am? Am I King of Kings, Lord of Lords? Am I your Savior? If so, you gotta believe that I am that I am. I am everything, thank you, Jesus, that you need for him to be. Jesus says, who do you say that I am? Do you say that he's your deliverer? Well, if so, then you gotta believe that he can deliver you from this perfect storm. Says, for as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there, but water the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. God is saying, it shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. So, how do we handle a perfect storm? Number one, seek God with all your heart. Number two, cry out to him. Number three, after you cry out to him, wait on the Lord without giving him a time to get back to you. Don't put a time on God. Number four, use his scriptures as your comfort as you wait. Number five, pray and let God know that you believe him to be the great I am. When I've gone through my perfect storm, faith is what brought me through. If you don't have faith, you're not going to make it through your perfect storm. It's going to linger and linger and linger. But what I can tell you is that when I was going through my perfect storm, I had to believe that God is who he says he is. I had to believe that God could do all, everything that he said he could do. I had to believe that he could heal my broken heart, and he did. But I had to believe it. I had to believe that no matter how much pain I was in, no matter how bad I felt, I had to believe that even though I couldn't see past the darkness that I was in, I had to believe that God was right there. I had to believe that he had my back. I had to believe it. That was the only way that I could get through my perfect storm. I had to believe that God was right here. I had to believe in every scripture that I've given you. I had to believe that he was going to heal my crushed heart. I had to believe that he was going to renew my spirit. So no matter what your circumstance, no matter what the situation is, no matter how bad your pain is, I think about, I love you guys, and I think about the pain that I was in, and I so want to. I wish I could fast forward your situation for you and let you see that if you believe in God, this is what it looks like. You can look back on your situation and your perfect storm, and you can help somebody else through their perfect storm the way I'm trying to help you. I wish I could do that, but I can't. You gotta go through this perfect storm. You have to deal with the elements that this perfect storm brought to you in order to be what you need to be for the next person. And number six, whenever you start feeling down, no matter where you are, praise his name. Tell him that you glorify him. Tell him that you give him all the glory. Let him know that you give him all your praise. Let him know that you give him the highest praise. Hallelujah to his name. No matter how down you are, I guarantee you that if you start praising God's name, no matter where you are, your spirit will be uplifted. This is not something someone told me or something I heard. This is something I know because I've gone through it. I've been at a point where I was so low and I was so down. I've been at a point where I was at work and all of a sudden something just hit me and I got so down. Well, all I had to do was go in that restroom, take a moment to praise God, let him know who he was, let him know that I believed in him, let him know that I believed that he is who he says he is. Let him know that I believe that he could do all things, including uplift my spirit. I gave him all my praises and my glory. It didn't take but a couple of minutes. After that, I was praising God. My spirit was uplifted, and whatever that darkness was that came over me, it was gone. Praise God. I praise God for his glory. I praise God for his goodness. Now, below this video, I did include for you scriptures that you can meditate on, that you can take comfort in, no matter what type of storm that you're going through. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us. To him be glory in the church and in Jesus Christ throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Until next time, you be blessed.
This hour, Jesus, Lord, you're my